Dear people, welcome to my presentation on ODD. I have been working with ODD for about 4 years, first because I wanted universal dependency-based linguistics in Frisian corpora, later because I wanted a strict TI and universal dependency-based dictionary format. I want to show you how ODD has helped me to deliver reliable, interoperable solutions. First, I will show you what ODD is. Then I will show you how ODD can be used in development pipelines. We will have a look at how ODDs can inherit from each other and have a glance at TI Publisher. Finally, I will share some pros and cons and the reasons why we at the Frieske Academy stick to ODD as basis for solution development. So what is an ODD? An ODD is a TI document in which you can define your data model using a schema spec. In the ODD, you can document your data model using TI elements such as div, p, gloss, and def. In this documentation, you can include the specifications to which you can refer from within schema spec. This gives you a nice way to specify your data model in a documented manner. Inside the specification of an element, you can indicate how this element is to be processed. We don't use this yet, but since the latest versions of TI Publisher, it has become a very interesting mechanism. Once you have your ODD, you can generate validation schemes, documentation, and more. So, here you see a basic example of a schema definition in ODD. Often the structure will be a schema spec with references to modules you want to work with and specifications of elements you want to change. The start attribute tells which root elements are allowed. Each module ref points to an existing module available in TI or elsewhere. A source attribute, left out in this example, allows you to point to the file where module definitions can be found. I will show you more on this later. To limit the vast number of elements in modules, you use the include or accept attributes on module ref. Note that if you omit an element in the include attribute and refer to it later from an element ref, schema generation will not fail, the element will just not be there. After the module references, you usually list some element specs for elements that you want to change. Note that omitting the mode attribute on element spec means add, not change. Adding already existing elements is weird, but again, often does not make transformation fail. Including content in an element specification will override existing content. The content of content resembles, for example, XSD. Basically, you can use sequence and alternate. A very nice feature, I think, is the ability to use constraints in element specifications. Most people will use Schematron with assert, report, and XPath. Besides elements, also attributes can be specified. In this case, I add linguistic feature attributes to the analysis module. These attributes can be defined in their own namespace. You can define the data type of attributes, which can be XML schema data type using a name attribute, or like here, a TEI data type using key. You can refer to previously defined attributes via member of. When an element is a member of an attribute class, the attributes defined in this class are allowed for that element. Note, the mode is change on classes. If you omit it, the default will be replace, meaning you will lose all other class memberships. More possibilities worth mentioning, but not in detail. The first two keep things organized. The model specifies element processing. Now, this is where the benefits really start. Once you have your ODD, you can construct a pipeline without the need for coding. That will give you validation and documentation, which you can use in, for example, editing environments like Oxygen. First thing to do is compile, or better said, expand your ODD using the available TEI stylesheet. The necessary parts from modules in the TEI source will be combined with your specifications. After this is done, you can transform to relaxing, again using the available stylesheet, or transform to a separate schematron. Relaxing can be transformed to XSD, which you may want to generate JuxB classes. Last but not least, there is a nice library that deals with the complexity of transforming schematron to XSLT, the execution of validation, and with the processing of validation results. You can also use Oxygen to transform, or OxGarage, or you can use Roma to construct ODD online, but the downside is this gives you less control and insight. And you get the version of TEI source and style sheets available in these tools at that time. This makes me really happy. Recently, I discovered it is possible, though verbose, to define a Maven pipeline that implements a lot of steps I mostly performed by hand before. Now I can just do MVN verify. No AND needed either, and no dependencies to online sources. On top of the available transformations from the TEI community, I found it very useful to write transformations from ODD. For example, to generate a configuration file for BlackLab, which in turn is used to build Lucene indices. Transformations like that help to stay consistent and in control, for example, in case of data model changes. Naturally, they can be included in Maven pipelines. Something about inheritance now. I must admit, I recently abandoned it because of added complexity and lack of use case. The basics are simple: write an ODD, compile it, write another ODD that uses the compiled first. The source attribute is crucial. You can specify it on schema spec, which means all module ref without a source attribute will retrieve their content from that source. All module ref with a source attribute will retrieve their content from there. An element ref can also have a source attribute, allowing you, for example, to re-add an element left out by the parent ODD. Despite these simple basics, it is kind of cumbersome to find out exactly which elements and modules come from exactly where, how they are defined, modified, etc. Rule of thumb: use fixed versions and keep it simple. Now, a glance at perhaps one of the most promising possibilities of ODD, especially when looking at the TEI publisher implementation of it. You can specify a processing model for elements. This allows you to decouple element definition from visual element behavior. A model defines behavior and can do so conditionally. You can provide parameters for the processing. Parameter values originate from the actual element at the time of processing. Output rendition should, I think, be avoided. Instead, rendition definition should be external, like SCSS and classes. TEI Publisher takes processing model a step further through the use of templates, web components, and XQuery instead of XPath. We will probably be using it for digital editions. These are some examples of solutions at the Frieske Academie. For Corpora, we generate BlackLab config and JavaScript from ODD, and we use the HTML stylesheet from TEI to build a fully functional corpus query system. For dictionaries, we generate Relaxing, XSD, and Schematron that are used in the validation helper, which is published to Maven Central. This library is then used in an app that publishes approved dictionary articles. An XSDB app allows querying the dictionary and presents results in either JSON or HTML. Another example is a library for linguistics in Corpora, where the generated XSD is translated into JaxB classes using an also generated bind.xml. This library is used in a Friesian lexicon service. I will now show you these three example applications. Firstly, I will show you the Friesian Corpora system based on BlackLab, especially focused on the relation with the ODD. So you have all kinds of search possibilities in this corpus linguistics system application. For example, you can search by POS tag, and you can directly see that some documentation pops up which originates from the ODD. Even more so, if you look at the values possible that you can choose here, also for the options, a documentation pops up. Same holds for the options you see here for example person, and another nice integration in this application is if you look at the content of some of these corpora. I pick one of the Yapix corpora. You can see, you can read the corpus itself. This is under the hood. This is of course a TEI document, which is very standard, hardly adapted. That's why we can use the HTML style sheet from the TEI community. Import that in our own style sheet, make some adaptations, for example, the word elements, and you can see if you hover over words, you see some documentation pop up, or you see that these words are, what you call them, compound words. Okay, and there's more to it. Okay, the next example is the dictionary. Under the hood, this is a rather restricted TI dictionary format, using the same terminology for linguistics. The basics is, you can, I see it's in Dutch, I'll change to English. Okay, so you can search for head words, which I do here. I search for dag, and then I can see already, I can see the terminology here, male and noun, which originates from the ODD. I can also restrict the searching here, search by head word. No, yes, I want to search for head word, and then I want to I want to restrict the searching to all verbs, and then I can look for dag, which is not a verb, so I will find nothing. But perhaps if I look for werk, yes, found something, which is a verb, and all the terminology you see here, for example, here you see the grammar and paradigm, and you see singular, etc. The grammar is standardized and it originates from the ODD. Sometimes you also have, I don't know if that's with this word, if that's the case with this word, but here you see some usage, I think. Yes, it's a USG concerning zaken, well, which is business. Okay, so that's a little bit about the integration of the ODD format into this dictionary application. Perhaps I just show you, it also has a web service. You can search for word forms. And then you will see the same results, the same search functionality, but instead of HTML you get JSON back, which is ideal of course for further processing in other applications. Then the last example I will give you from an application is the Frisian Lemma service, which is a word service allowing you to search for words. For example, I will give you the word to work, which is work here in Frisian, and you can see that you get a lemma back, and it is a noun, werkje in this case, but you can also see the next one, the next hit. The next homonym is probably a verb, which I can see here, and it's also preferred, etc. And it has some Dutchisms, and it doesn't have a lot of synonyms, but it has some synonyms. And again, the same linguistic terminology is used in this application as well. Okay, I'll switch back to the presentation. Wrapping up, I give you a list of pros and cons of ODD-based developments. The pros weigh heavier for us. Perhaps the most problematic in practice is the complexity of the development pipelines. They often consist out of multiple generation and publication steps and possibly inherited dependencies. For me, as a Java adept, it is a pity that TI focuses on relaxing, not on XSD. I really like and benefit from JAX-B and still hope XSD 1.1 will be a success and find its way into follow-up JAX-B. For us at the Frieske Academy, there are a lot of reasons to stick to our ODD-based approach. Perhaps I raised some curiosity that will lead to increased use of ODD, which in turn will lead to a load of GitHub issues on ODD that will be solved, improving the usability of ODD. Thank you. Thank you for watching. My live version will now be available if you have any questions.